So we were in this fourth module, the last module of this subject. Okay, we have done about NBFCs and microfinance. Okay, today I'll just go through this leasing because generally a theory doesn't come from this part because a problem is there compulsory in your case study of 20 marks. So there are two types of problems. One comes for the leasing and another problem comes for hire purchase. So either of these two will come here, either leasing or fir hire purchase. Okay, so just I'll go through this leasing. Anyways, they'll join. The problem is more important. Okay, and so leasing is just I'll read it. A lease is a form of a contract transferring the use of occupancy of land, space, structure, or equipment in consideration of payment, usually in the form of a rent. Okay, so basically, it is a rent. There are two people in this leasing contract. So one will be a lessee, one will be a lesser. Lesser is a person who has the equipment or the land or the space or the apartment. So he is giving it on lease, and lessee is the person who is taking it on lease. Okay, so there are two parties basically, lesser and a lessee in lease contract. So lease is not a sale. Okay, lease is renting anything. Okay, renting a bike or renting a car, renting a land, renting an apartment, renting an equipment, renting a machine or a factory or a hotel, anything else, anything. Okay, that involves leasing. So in leasing, there are two people. Lesser is a person who has the right to use the asset in consideration of payment periodically under lease agreement, and lessee is the person who obtains from the lesser to use the asset. Okay, so he is the lesser is the person who is providing the asset, and lessee is the person who is using the asset, and he is paying a lease rent to the lesser. Okay, so this is what is there about lessee and lesser. Okay, there are various types of leasing. Okay, again, I'll go through this. Financial lease, the first one. Financial lease is the lease where the agreement or the leasing period is for a very long time. Okay, suppose I'm taking a land on lease. Okay, the land always, whenever we nowadays we buy any land. So that land is on lease from the government. Okay, so the lease period is somewhat 60 years or 90 years, like that. Okay, we are not the whole and sole owner of any land which we buy. Okay, so that is somewhat on a lease basis. Okay, definitely the lease will be extended afterwards, or maybe what will happen, I don't know. But it is a certain kind of a lease period. Okay, somewhat 50 or 70 years. So that is a different kind of lease. Okay, that is the reason we are paying our tax on that. So financial lease generally it happens also in industries where if I'm buying a machine on a rent, and that machine I'm going to use it for 20 years or 30 years, like that. Okay, or 15 to 20 years. Okay, so then I'll go for a financial lease. Okay, so everything I'll take care of that machine. Even if something happens to that machine or anything, I'll take care of it. Okay, so financial lease for a long period of time. Okay, the opposite of that, operating lease is generally for a short period of time, maybe 3 years or 5 years, like that, or maybe 2 years. Okay, so operating lease can be a rent on home or renting a car or anything like that. So the expected useful value of that equipment or the asset which we are using is very less. Okay, so I'm not going to use it for 10 or 20 or 50 years. So it is very short period of time, maybe 3 years or 5 years. So in that, the operating expenses will be borne by the lessee, and the remaining thing will be borne by the lesser. Okay, so in financial lease, everything was basically on the lessee side. Who has taken the equipment on lease, he will take care of that machine. Okay, in operating lease, he'll take care of only about the operating expenses, not any major damage if happens to machine, or major fault is there in the machine, then the lessee will not take care of it. The lesser will be taking care of it. Okay, the general maintenance and all those stuff. Then lease and sale back. Lease and sale back is the person who can get the machine. Okay, but he is he will not he is not able to pay the entire amount of that machine. So he is selling that machine to a lessor and taking it lease back. Okay, suppose there is a machine I want it in my factory, and I have seen that machine somewhere in maybe in Germany. Okay, so I'll ask the bank to buy it from me. Okay, the bank will buy that machine, and I'll sell that machine to another industrialist. Okay, and that machine I'll take it from lease to him. Okay, I'll be using that machine, and I'll be paying the lease rental to that industrialist. Okay, definitely the lease rental will be more, and the cost of the machine will be the total lease amount as compared to the cost of the machine will be more. So the industrialist will have a profit. Okay, so 1 crore ka machine hai, so lease rental will be maybe 10 lakhs for maybe 20 years, so that the cost of the machine is only 1 crore and I am paying him 1.5 or 1.6 crores yeah, over a period of 10 years. So he is also in the profit. Okay, so lease and sale back is I'm selling the machine to a person and I'm taking back the machine. The ownership is there with him, but the usage of that machine is done by me, and I'm paying him lease rental. The sale and lease back. मतलब पहले sale कर दिया, then I'm leasing it back. Okay, then direct lease. Okay, direct lease is again a type of a combination of financial and operating lease. Either direct lease can be a two-tier lease. Two party, lesser and lessee, only two will be there, or three party will be there, like in a sale and lease back, which I've told. A bank will be there, a lesser and a lessee, or the equipment seller, lesser and lessee, three party will be there. Okay, leveraged sir, lease, yeah.
Sir, Sarika is waiting.
Again, acha, yeah. Okay. Okay, a leverage lease. Leverage lease is when the cost of the equipment is very high, okay, in crores. Then I'll take loan from the bank, or I'll take a leverage from any financial institution, and then I'll do the leasing of that. Okay, then I'll you take that machine on lease. End up loan leke, I'll take a lease. That's it. Okay, cross border lease is when the lease is. When the machine is outside the country, and I'm taking that machine and I'm paying it, paying the lease rental to the foreign company. Okay, cross border lease. It's basically an international lease. Okay, consumer leasing. Consumer leasing is for the consumer durables. Okay, refrigerator, fridge. Refrigerator, washing machine. All those equipments will be taken on lease rental. ठीक है, वाई पीपल टेक दिस इफ सपोज आई एम गोइंग टू एनी सपोज आई हैव बीन ट्रांसफर टू चेन्नई एंड आई एम ओनली सर्विंग इन अ कंपनी फॉर टू ईयर्स ठीक है सो ओनली आई एम गोइंग टू स्टे इन चेन्नई फॉर ओनली फॉर टू ईयर्स बट आई नीड ऑल द इक्विपमेंट्स इन माई हाउस आई नीड अ रेफ्रिजरेटर आई नीड अ वॉशिंग मशीन आई नीड अ टेलीविजन आई नीड अ एयर कंडीशन ओके ऑल दीज फोर थिंग्स आई नीड So I'll not buy that, or I'll not take it from here to Chennai, everything. Okay, so that will be a huge cost for me also. And again, taking it back from Chennai to Belgaum. So to avoid that transportation, and also avoiding to buy that thing in my house in Chennai, I lease the refrigerator, this AC and washing machine just for 2 years. And later on, when I'll be leaving Chennai and coming back to Belgaum, I'll give it back. So consumer leasing is that way. Okay, then there are balloon leasing. Balloon leasing is after the lease period, the cost of the machine is nothing. It is zero. It means if I have leased a machine for a period of 10 years, the depreciation of that machine is almost zero after 10 years. Okay, the value of that machine will be zero. The depreciation will be such that the value of the machine, the scrap value of that machine at the end of 10 years will be zero. Okay, so in that kind of leasing, initially the lease rent is low, then it increases in the mid years, and then again it decreases at the end of the year. That means if it is a 10 years of lease, if I have चलो कंसिडर दिस, आई हैव नॉट बॉट अ कार बट आई हैव टेकन अ कार फ्रॉम फॉर लीज फ्रॉम अ शोरूम इटसेल्फ। ओके, कार शोरूम का ऐसा कोई स्कीम है इन दैट दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड मी अ कार फॉर यूजिंग इट फॉर 10 ईयर्स। ओके, एंड द डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द कार आफ्टर द डेप्रिसिएशन अमाउंट इज सच दैट आफ्टर 10 ईयर्स द स्क्रैप वैल्यू ऑफ दैट कार विल बी जीरो। सो इनिशियली आई'ल कीप ऑन पेइंग द लीज। ओके, आई विल बी पेइंग लीज रेंटल फॉर द एंटायर पीरियड ऑफ 10 ईयर्स। इनिशियली द लीज रेंटल विल बी लेस, मे बी फॉर 1 or 2 or 3 ईयर्स लीज रेंटल कम रहेगा। देन फ्रॉम 4th, 5th, 6th ईयर द लीज रेंटल विल बी वेरी हाई। देन अगेन आफ्टर 7, 8 ईयर्स एंड 9 and 10 ईयर्स द लीज रेंटल विल गो ऑन रिड्यूसिंग। सो इट इज काइंड ऑफ अ बेल कर्व। ओके, इनिशियली लो देन हाई देन अगेन लो, दैट इज वॉट बलून लीजिंग इज। ओके, दिस सम वंस इट हैज कम टाइप्स ऑफ लीजिंग। ओके, सो दैट्स इट। हायर परचेज आई डू इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास इटसेल्फ आफ्टर ड्यूरिंग दैट सम। ओके, सो नाउ आई विल गो थ्रू अ न्यूमेरिकल विच दिस जनरली क्यों नहीं एडमिट हो। ओके, डोंट वरी अबाउट दिस, आई विल बी शेयरिंग द पीपीटी विथ यू। ओके, वन थिंग आई कैन डू, I'll share the question in the group itself so that you can refer it. No, you will not be able to. Okay, I'll send it and keep it. Okay, I've sent this screenshot in group as well. Okay, you can refer it if you cannot see this. Okay, so in this kind of a problem, I'll just give a brief how the problem is. Okay, so there will be a problem in which in this type of problem on leasing. The problem is there will be a company. Okay, company wants some machinery for its use for a period of 5 years or 10 years. Okay, so that is the range in which the company is going to use that machine. Company is deciding whether to lease that machine for that period of 5 years or whether to take loan from the bank and buy the machine. Okay, so there are two options with the company: either to go for lease or whether to buy that machine by taking a loan from the bank. ठीक है, दो ऑप्शन है, लीज पे लेना है या खरीदना है. Okay, so how they will decide which option is better? Whichever option has less cash outflow, that option the company will select. Okay, because the cost of the machine is same. Okay, but the cash outflow, okay, over a period of 5 years, how the leasing will be there, what is the lease rental over a period of 5 years, and what is the EMI payment to the bank over a period of 5 years, these two things I will compare, and then whichever cash outflow, जिधर भी खर्चा कम हो रहा है, whichever alternative the cash outflow is less, that alternative the company will select. So we need to first find out the cash outflow from lease rental, then cash outflow from the EMI option, the buying option. So these two things we are going to calculate: the cash outflow from lease rental, cash outflow because of the buying option through EMI. So whichever cash outflow will be less, that we will select. So it is a pretty big problem. You can see 14 slides are there. Okay, 13 slides are there. Okay, so in this there are many calculations, but you have done this calculation in your FM as well and in your accounts as well. Okay, so no new calculations is there. Just the structuring of the problem is such that it becomes a huge problem, and it comes for 20 marks, so it is worth it. Okay, I'll read this. XYZ is in the business of manufacturing steel utensils. The firm is planning to diversify and add new product line. The firm can either buy the product, buy the required machinery, or get it on lease. So two options here: whether to buy a machine or whether to get it on lease. The machine can be purchased for 15 lakhs. So cost of the machine is 15 lakhs. It is expected to have a useful life of 5 years with a salvage value of 1 lakh rupees after expiry of 5 years. Okay, so cost of the machine 15 lakhs, expected value 5 years, ठीक है, दैट मीन्स 5 ईयर्स तक यूज करेंगे मशीनरी, एंड आफ्टर यूसेज ऑफ 5 ईयर्स द स्क्रैप वैल्यू और द सेल्वेज वैल्यू आफ्टर डेप्रिसिएशन इट विल बी 1 लाख. सो आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स व्हेन आई एम थ्रोइंग द मशीन आई कैन आई नॉट जस्ट थ्रो इट, आई सेल इट इन आई सेल इट समवेयर एंड आई गेट 1 लाख ऑफ रुपीज, दैट इज द स्क्रैप वैल्यू आफ्टर द 5 ईयर्स, आफ्टर द एक्सपायरी ऑफ 5 ईयर्स. देन द परचेज कैन बी फाइनेंस बाय 20% लोन रीपेबल इन 5 इक्वल एनुअल इंस्टॉलमेंट्स. ओके, in this EMI payment is not monthly payment, it is not EMI actually, okay, it is EAI, what you can call it. So it is an annual payment, okay, of 5 equal installments. That is, at the end of every year I am going to pay the loan, okay, so there will be 5 installments at the end of 20 year and at the end of 5 at the end of every year, and with a interest of 20%. Okay, becoming due at the end of each. Alternatively, okay, now there is second option. This was the first option. Okay, 20% interest pay, I'll take a loan and I'll pay 5 equal installments. Or alternatively, the machine can be taken on lease rent of 4,50,000. Or another option is, I'll take that machine on lease and every year I'll pay 4,50,000. Okay, so 5 times I'll pay 4,50,000. Okay, if I take it on lease, advise the company which option it should choose. For your exercise, you may assume the following. Okay, the machine will constitute a separate block for depreciation. The company follows written down value of depreciation. Rate of depreciation is 25%. Okay, I hope you know this. Okay, and, the cost of machine is 15 lakhs. Okay, 5 lakh is the period where we are going to use that machine, and we are going to depreciate every year the value of machine, and the depreciation rate is WDV method, written down value method, and the rate is 25%. So 15 ka 25%, I'll remove it. Then whatever it whatever is remaining, maybe 12 lakh something, then I'll depreciate again 25% from it. Then the after 2 years, the cost of the machine will be somewhere 9 lakhs or something. So the cost of machine will go on reducing till 5 years. Okay, the tax rate is 35% and cost of capital is 18%. Okay, so in this second one, the tax rate is important, 35%. The cost of capital 18%, we are not going to use it in the sum. It is just given for the reference and not even for the reference. Okay, this is a dummy figure. Okay, we are not going to use cost of capital anywhere. Then lease rent is to be paid by the end of the year. Okay. Yeah, just at the end of the year I'm going to pay. Okay, there will be some modification in the another problems, and maintenance expenses estimated at 30,000 are to be borne by the lessee. Okay, this 30,000 maintenance expenses is generally borne by the lessee itself. Okay, the lessor doesn't bear it. So in the problem, even in the problem, 30,000 will be ignored, because anyways the maintenance is always paid by the lessee. Either it is a operating lease or a financial lease, 30,000 jo maintenance expenses hai, jo bhi maintenance expenses hai, always it is borne by the lessee. Who has taken the machine, wahi bear karta hai. Okay, so even this we will ignore. If suppose in the problem it is mentioned that it is borne by the lessor, okay, who has given us the machine, he will bear the maintenance expenses. In that case, we will reduce that expenses from our lease rental. Kyunki hum logo fayda ho raha hai. He is taking care of that machine. Okay, so it is not such thing in this problem. Okay, any doubts about the question?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, Anisha is waiting.
Ah, okay. No, yeah, no one is waiting. And generally it is auto admit. I mean, yeah, let's see. Okay. Any doubts in the question? The question is pretty big. question is pretty big, but it's not that difficult to solve. It is just the problem, it is lengthy. Okay, if you have any paper, you can just scribble down. This is because this is your first assignment. Okay, and for the assignments, I'll only give you problems. There will be three problems for three assignments, that's it. Okay, and this is the part of your, this is the first assignment of yours. Okay, chalo. I'll start with the slideshow itself. Okay. So explanation, okay, in this problem, the company needs to decide which alternative to select, whether to go for leasing or whether to go for buying. Okay, buying kaise karenge? They will take loan from the bank and they'll buy the machine and they'll keep on paying the five installments over a period of 5 years. Okay, and that installments we will going to compare with the lease rental payment. And I'm going to calculate the cash outflows present value. That's the thing we are going to find out. The present value of that cash outflows we are going to find out. Okay, so these two things I'm going to decide, whether to buy the machine or to take it on lease. And we are going to calculate the cash outflows from these two. And whichever cash outflows is less, that we are going to select. Okay, so first part of the solution is, we will first calculate the cash outflows from leasing alternative. Agar we are going to take lease, okay, so what will be the cash outflows of the company? That we are going to find out first. So see, in the problem, it is given 20% is the rate of interest. Okay, and this 20% we will consider even for the lease calculation because we want to keep it similar. Okay, the lease and the buying alternative, we want to keep it similar. So 20% is the rate which we will be using even for the leasing calculation. It is kind of a, what do you say, the cost of capital also. The cost of capital, which it is given 18%, that we are not going to consider. We are going to consider 20% for the that time value of money consideration, like that. Okay, and the tax component is removed from the interest rate, and this will be considered for lease rent calculation. This is what I'm talking about. Okay, see here. The present value I'm going to calculate of cash outflow under leasing alternative. This is the first part I'm going to do in this solution. I'm going to calculate the present value of cash outflows from leasing alternative. If you remember from the question, the it is 4,50,000 the company is paying as a leasing lease payment every year. Okay, so 4,50,000 every year, 4,50,000 first year, 4,50,000 second year, third year, fourth year, and fifth year. But I'm going to calculate the present value of that 4,50,000. Okay, so for present value, I need a present value factor. So this is how I'll be finding out the present value factor. 20 is the rate of interest. Okay, 1 minus tax rate. Tax rate is 35%. So 35% hai to 0.35 I've written. So 13% is the PV factor, which I have got. Okay, 20% rate of interest, 1 minus 0.35, 1 minus tax rate. I have got 13% as the this PV factor. Using this PV factor, I'm going to calculate the present value of future cash outflows of the leasing alternative. Okay, so lease rent given is 4,50,000. Okay, tax component is removed from the lease rent. Okay, we have removed it. 1 minus tax rate. Okay. So this is the lease after tax lease rent. Rent, which is 4,50,000 into 1 minus tax rate. 1 minus 0.35. So 2,92,500 is the lease payment for every year. Okay, I have removed the tax component of it. Jitna bhi tax bharna hai usko nikal ke itna rent actual I am going to pay. Okay, so this is what the calculation is. This is the first table which you are going to make. Okay, year end, 5 years lease rent hai. Lease rent is 2,92,500 for every year. Okay, PV factor at 13%. Okay, 13% ka this, how this value I have got from PVIF table. सो प्रेजेंट वैल्यू टेबल है, उसमें से आई हैव गॉट ऑल दीज वैल्यूज फॉर 13% वन फर्स्ट ईयर, 13% सेकेंड ईयर, 13% थर्ड ईयर, 13% फोर्थ ईयर, 13% फिफ्थ ईयर. And I'm going to calculate the cash outflows. I'm multiplying lease rent into PV factor and I'm getting the cash outflows and I'm doing sum of this and I'm getting 10,28,720 as the total net cash outflow, the PV present value for the 5 years of lease rent. Okay, this is what I'll get it. Okay. Till now, anything which you have not understood? See, we started from here. 20% we took for the calculation. We calculated the PV factor. Okay, I have removed tax component from the PV factor and I have calculated 20% into 1 minus tax. I have calculated 13%. Then again, I calculated the lease rent, after tax lease rent. This was the lease rent given in the question. After tax lease rent I have calculated, which is this much. So this will be considered for the cash outflows. So two things we have calculated. This 2,92,000 lease rent for every year, 13% PV factor. Then after this, I just multiplied these two and I've got this net cash outflows. And I've done total I have done total of this and I got this 10 lakhs. So this 10,28,000 is the cash outflow from the leasing alternative. Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
No, okay, we did with the leasing calculation. Lease se kitna, what is the cash flow I'm going to bear. Now I'll go for the buying alternative. If I buy that machine by taking loan from the bank, what is the cash outflows? Okay, so this is pretty big. Okay, cost of the machine is 15 lakhs. As the loan installment is not given in the question, we will calculate it as below. Okay, it is told that 20% is the rate of interest. The cost of the machine is 15 lakhs. The period of loan is 5 years. So these three information we have. Cost of the machine 15 lakhs, rate of interest 20%, and the period of loan is 5 years. And again, the loan installment is 5 installments. Okay, so this is how we will calculate. Okay. 15 lakhs is the cost of the machine. I'll use PVIFA table. Okay, annuity. Okay, a present value, interest factor, annuity. I hope you know this, how to set the table and get it. Okay, okay. After this sum, I'll just go through even that as well. So 20% for 5 years, I'll check in the PVIFA table. Okay, I'll divide this 15 lakhs with that amount and I'll get this. 5 lakhs is the per year installment which I have got. In that lease rent we have calculated by removing the tax. Here we have not yet removed the tax. We have just calculated what is the per year installments. Okay. In this sum it has not been given, but most of the time this installment will also be given in the question. Okay. If it is given in the question, you don't need to do all this. Otherwise, just the cost of the machine divided by the PVIFA for the 20% interest and 5 years. Okay, this is before tax. Okay, so 5 lakhs 1,505 is the installment per year. Okay, then I'll make the schedule of debt repayment. During offline classes I got to know you have studied this in financial management, but still don't worry if you don't remember. Okay, not that difficult. These are things you need to, this is how you need to make a table. Okay, year end payment hai. Loan in the beginning of the year. Okay, what is the loan? How much loan you are pending to pay in the beginning of the year? Rate at the rate 20%. I'll take 20% of this amount. then installments, which is 5 lakh 1000 whatever, the installment will remain same for all this. Then principal we will calculate. Principal is the installment which you have, which you are paying minus the interest which you are paying. That is the amount of principal. Then whatever is remaining is the loan outstanding for that end year end. That means the loan at the beginning of the year minus principal, how much you have paid, that is the loan outstanding or the cost of the machine at the end of the price of the machine at the end of that year, which you are remaining to pay. Okay, so this is the first one. Year one, loan in the beginning of the year, 15 lakhs ka machine hai. Okay, so this is the cost of the machine. On 15 lakhs, I'm going to pay 20% of interest. So 20% of 15 lakhs is 3 lakhs. So this is the interest amount. This is the interest amount, which is the part of the installment. That means 5 lakhs of installment, which I'm paying. From that 5 lakhs, 3 lakhs is the interest rate. 3 lakhs is the interest rate. So remaining is 2 lakhs, which is the part of the principal. So 15 lakhs, जो है मशीन का कॉस्ट, फ्रॉम दैट 2 lakhs इज बीन पेड एज द प्रिंसिपल, रिमेनिंग इज पेड एज द इंटरेस्ट फ्रॉम दिस. सो इंस्टॉलमेंट कंटेन्स टू पार्ट्स, वन पार्ट इज इंटरेस्ट, वन पार्ट इज प्रिंसिपल. सो इंटरेस्ट आई एम गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट यूजिंग द कॉस्ट ऑफ द मशीन विच इज एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ द ईयर. ओके, फ्रॉम दैट दिस इंटरेस्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिडक्ट इट फ्रॉम द इंस्टॉलमेंट्स एंड आई विल गेट द प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट. Then loan outstanding at the end of the year, this 12 lakhs, how I've got this, the loan at the beginning of the year minus the principal amount, this minus this, I have got 12,98,000. Any doubts? Okay. If no doubts, then again, for the second year, I'm going to tell. Second year will be the loan at the beginning of the second year will be this amount. Okay, so this 12,98,000 will come here. Okay, and the process continues. Okay, so this at the end of the first year, what is the cost of the machine? That same cost of the machine is at the beginning of second year. And again, 20% of this will be written here. Okay, installment is same. How will I get this? Installment minus interest, I'll get this. And again, how will I get the loan outstanding? The loan at the beginning of the year, 12 lakhs minus 2,41,000, I'll get 10 lakhs. Again, this amount will come here at the beginning of third year. Again, 20% interest on this, installment minus interest principal amount, which I have paid. Then loan outstanding, this loan in the beginning minus the principal, this. So again, this will come at the start of the fourth year, and 20% of this installment minus this. So it goes on. Okay, the fifth year is very important. Why? Because the loan outstanding at the end of fifth year should be zero. Okay, generally because we are not considering a point. Over here, 0.56. We are not doing it very accurate, okay, and don't need to do also very accurately, okay, not required. The thing is, we are not getting exactly zero over here. Sometimes we will get 10 rupees or 50 rupees or 200 rupees or 300 rupees, like that amount in loan outstanding. So because of that, I need to make it somehow zero. So if it is not coming zero, I will increase some amount in interest rate to make it zero. Okay, for example, see this 4,18,000, it came here directly. In this, after this step, what we do a 20% interest rate of this and write it here. But in the final step, we'll not do like that. First, I'll make it zero, this thing. I'll write 5 lakh, this is the installment, which this will remain same. Okay, I'll do A minus D. What is A? This minus D should be zero. That means A and D should be equal. This should, whatever the amount is there at the beginning of the year, the entire principal amount is paid. So these two figures you need to make it same. so that this will be zero. Okay, now I am I have installments 5 lakhs. In the previous steps, what we were doing, installment minus interest, I was getting principal. Now I have got principal already, so I'll do installment minus principal to get the interest. So this is how I'll get this. And from the entire table, only this column is important for the numerical. Okay, how much is the interest rate which I'll be paying? Okay, any doubts? I know this is your first time studying it like this. Okay, so there might be a confusion. So I'll repeat it again if it is required in the next class also. Okay, or else if you practice it also, then you will get to know how the thing is going on. Okay, shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, then I'll make a schedule of depreciation. This is quite simple. Okay, 15 lakhs is the cost of my machine. Okay, multiplied by 0.25. What is 0.25? This is the rate of depreciation, 25%. 25% is the rate of depreciation, WDV. So this is the amount of depreciation which I got. 25% ka depreciation laga, 15 lakhs pe. So the remaining balance is 15 lakhs minus 3,75,000, I'll get balance. So this is the cost of machine at the end of 1 year. So at the beginning of the year, the cost of machine was 15 lakhs. So I used the machine for a period of 1 year. So usme depreciation amount, something wear and tear ho gaya, and the and I have applied depreciation on that 15 lakhs of machine, and the cost of the machine now is 11 lakhs at the end of first year. So this will be the cost of machine at the beginning of second year, and I'll apply again depreciation, then I'll get a balance of this. So again I'll do and apply. Okay, so this is how I'll get after the end of fifth year. After the end of fifth year, this is my cost of machine, 3,55,000. Okay, I don't think I need to explain this much more. Okay, I'm just depreciating the machine using written down value method. Okay, suppose, okay, in this sum it is WDV method. Suppose in the another type of numerical, you can get a straight line method. Okay, if SLM comes, then you don't need to do all this. Okay, you can directly calculate what is the depreciation value. Okay, you can take 15 lakhs divided by 5 lakhs. That will be your straight line method. Okay, you don't need to make a schedule of depreciation. If you want, you can make it also in straight line method also. So this is what the schedule of depreciation in using WDV. Now in this depreciation amount which I have got, this is important. Okay, in the previous sum, the interest rate column was important. In the previous table, interest rate column was important. In this table, the depreciation amount, this one, is important. We are going to use it. Okay. So why we are going to use this is we have not removed tax component anything from this till now. Okay, in the lease. In the leasing part, we have removed tax from here. Okay, and we have removed tax from here, from the rent as well. So rent se bhi tax ko nikal diya, aur iske liye PV factor ke liye bhi, the percentage se bhi, we have removed tax from this. But in the buying alternative, we have not removed tax from this. Nor anything tax, कुछ भी नहीं है इधर. Schedule of debt repayment में, schedule of depreciation में, tax is not there. So I'll not remove it from here. I'll instead write the tax advantage which I get, and then I'll remove it in the next part. Okay. See how, what will I do? This is what we are going to do. See, in year one, the interest, what we have got is 3 lakhs of rupees. Okay, from that schedule of debt repayment table, you will get year one interest is 3 lakhs. I'm going to check what is the tax which I am going to pay before this interest. Okay, why we are doing this is, you remember EBIT, earnings before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization, EBITDA rehta hai. From that EBITDA, we removed amortization and depreciation. Then we get EBIT. From EBIT, we remove interest. Then we get EBT. Then we remove tax from this. So I need to calculate what is the advantage I am getting because I have taken interest. What is the advantage I have applied depreciation on my machine? So what is the advantage, tax advantage I am getting because of these two things, because of interest and because of depreciation? Suppose interest is zero, then I'll not, then my EBIT and EBT will be same. There is no interest. Okay, so I'm not getting any advantage. But if I have taken a loan and I'm paying interest, so I'll get an advantage on tax. That I'm going to calculate, that we are going to calculate here. So for year one, interest into one minus into one into tax, or it's basically a tax. So how much is the tax which I'm going to pay? Depreciation into the tax. This is the year one depreciation advantage which I'm getting for tax. Similarly for year two, the second year interest into 1 into 1.35, second year depreciation depreciation amount into 1 into 1.35. similarly we'll go do for 3, 4 and 5 years. Okay, again I'll just go through. 3 lakhs kidhar se aaya, 3 lakhs kidhar se aaya, interest ke columns. Okay, 3 lakhs, okay, 3 lakhs into 1 into 0.35. 0.35 is the tax rate. Similarly, 2,59,000 from here I have got. Okay, 2,59,000. From where I got this depreciation amount, I have got depreciation amount from here. 3,75,000, 2,81,000. Yes, I got it from here. 3,75,000, 2,81,000. Okay, into tax. Similarly, I'll do it for 3, 4 and 5th year. Now, this is the last table, okay, of this numerical. So in this, these are the headings. Year, 5 years, we are going to write it down. Installments, this will be same. 5 lakhs, which we installments we have, which we have got. Okay, tax advantage for interest and depreciation. This column will include all the amounts which we have got here. 1,05,000, 90,895 for interest. For depreciation, 1,31,250, 98,437. Okay, and for 3, 4, and 5 also. Okay, you can write this or you can directly calculate it here. For year, first year, the interest will be 3 lakhs into the tax rate. Then next year, the second rate, second year interest into tax rate, third year interest into tax rate, fourth year interest into tax rate. Similarly, for depreciation, first year depreciation into tax, second year depreciation into tax, third year depreciation into tax, fourth year depreciation into tax, like that you can do. Okay. Then next is net outflow. You will calculate installments minus interest minus depreciation is the net outflow. Okay, just see this. Year one, installment, the loan installment. Okay, 1,05,000. How we have got this from the previous slide? Okay. The first year interest rate into tax rate. Okay, we have got this. Similarly, depreciation, first year depreciation into tax rate. And net outflow is installment minus interest minus depreciation is this amount. Why we are doing a minus of these two figures? Because we are getting an advantage. So this is saving our cash outflow. Okay, as this is saving our cash outflow, our outflow is not 5 lakhs. 5 lakh installment pay to kar rahe, but we are saving some in we are saving because some tax advantage we are getting on interest and depreciation. So this is the actual cash outflow from the installments. Okay, this is how we have removed tax from this. figure, installment. Okay, as I've told you, installment say tax, we have not removed it. Here we have removed it now. Okay, again a PV factor of 13%. Again 13% kaise aaya? Again we tax nikal ke 20% into 1 minus tax rate. So we have got PV factor as 13%. So similarly, this multiplied by this, we have got PV of outflow. So this table is similar to the leasing table. Okay, in that lease rent was there and PV factor was there, and PV of outflow we were getting. So installment will remain same. This again second year interest rate into tax, second year depreciation into tax. This is this minus this minus this, we have got net outflow. Again multiply with the PV factor, we have got a PV of cash outflow. Same for year 3, 4, and 5. No change. Okay, PV factor, again these are same, we have got from the PVIF table, or this will be same which we have used for the leasing calculation also. Jo lease mein calculation mein PV factor tha, same PV factor will come here. And this is the cash outflow, and this is the total cash outflows. I have added all this and I have got PV of cash outflows. Okay, and one more thing we have left it. Okay, generally what we will be doing, we will compare the PV of outflow for buying alternative with PV of outflow from the leasing alternative. So lease mein se kitna outflow tha and buying mein kitna outflow hai, that two we are going to compare. Okay, so one thing we have left in this 11 lakhs jo bhi aaya hai. Okay, we have got cash outflow as 11 lakhs from buying alternative. But ek aur cheez tha, there is a salvage value of 1 lakh rupees. In the numerical it is given that after a period of 5 years, the machine will have a salvage value of rupees 1 lakh. We have not considered salvage value in leasing. Why? Because we will be going to return back that machine to the lesser. Okay, wo hum log rakhenge nahi machine. After 5 years, wo machine wapis le lega. Lease pe liya hai na. So he'll take back the machine. So salvage value consideration is not there for leasing. But salvage value consideration will be there when we buy that machine. Jab hum log khareedenge machine, okay, after 5 years that machine will be ours. Okay, so after 5 years anyways we are not going to use that machine, we are going to sell it in the market as a scrap. So that scrap value or the salvage value is given as 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so we need to reduce this from the cash outflow. Okay, one more thing is, yeah, from this schedule of depreciation we have got the cost of machine as 3,55,000. Matlab 5 saal ke baad mein the cost of the machine will be 3 lakhs, but how much the question is telling us, it is 1 lakh of rupees. So 2 lakhs ka we are facing a loss. So that 2 lakh loss we are going to calculate, and we are reducing it from the cash outflow kyunki ye loss hai hum log ka, to is pe bhi tax advantage milega humko. Okay, so two more things two more calculation is needed here. 1 lakh ka tax advantage, sorry 1 lakh ka present value, and 2,55,000 ka loss which we are bearing, us pe tax advantage and uska pv factor. Yeah, see here, cash outflow is this much, okay, from the buying alternative. Present value of salvage value, okay, 0.543, from where I have got this, I have got this from the 5th year PV factor. 13% ka jo PV factor which we have taken, the 5th year ka, after 5 years we are going to sell that machine at rupees 1 lakh. So after 5 years, so this is the PV value and this is the salvage value. So the present value of that salvage value is 54,000. So jo 1 lakh hai after a period of 5 years, wo abhi the value is 54,000 present value. And one more thing we have present value of tax savings on short term capital loss. That means a loss hai 3,55,000 we have got from the schedule of depreciation. This is the cost of machine after 5 years, and 1 lakh is the salvage value which we will get it after selling the machine. So this much is the total loss, 2,55,000 ka loss hai. Okay, that uske upar Okay, one thing I forgot to. This is the loss which I have borne because of the difference in the calculation of machine. This is the interest advantage. Okay, 0.35 se multiply kiya, interest rate se multiply kiya. This is the tax advantage which we have received because of that loss. And that amount, I am going to multiply it by 0.543 because we are calculating present value. Okay, so three things are there. The cost of the machine, the loss of the machine, which we have received, tax advantage because of that loss, and the present value of that loss. So that we have got as 48,000. Okay. As by the practice, we'll get to, if you write it down the entire sum, then you'll get to know what is happening here. So this is the final figure which I have got because of the buying alternative. Okay, now I am going to compare it. Leasing alternative, from the first part I have got 10,28,000 here, I guess. Yeah, 10,28,000. 10,28,000 we have got by calculation of lease rent. Okay, and I have got this by the buying alternative. If I take a loan from the bank and buy that machine, I will be having this much cash outflows. So I'm going to compare this, which one is less, leasing alternative is less or buying alternative is less, which one is less? Okay, this one, leasing. So that's the reason we will advise the company for go for the leasing alternative. Okay, that means this is less costly for us. Okay, it is this is the cheaper option from these two alternative. Okay, I know many of you might be thinking bahut bada hi samay to mushkil hoga, but if you, I'll do two or three sums like that, and this was the most difficult sum which I have selected, and it contains everything. Okay, in this sum you don't have the lease rent properly given, you don't have first of all EMI, the annual installments is also not given, that we have found out. The depreciation was written down method. If it is straight line method, there is no need to calculation of that depreciation every year. Okay, so all those things were there, but these three, four tables will definitely be there. This table, kitna lease rent hai and kitna PV factor hai. Calculate the outflows, add it. Then, if you have installments given in the problem, no need to calculate all this. Directly installment leke, you can make a schedule of debt repayment. Okay. This table will be there in every sum. Har sum mein aise hi table banana hai. Okay. This is the thing which you need to remember. Loan outstanding at the end of final year, last year, this will be zero. So for this to be zero, your principal and your loan at the beginning of the year should be same. Ye aur ye same rahega. And your installments definitely will always be same for every year. So this I will calculate. By using this installment minus the principal, I'll calculate this. This column will be important, interest column. The next is schedule of depreciation. This depreciation amount is important. If it is straight line method, no need to make this. Okay, then this was important, tax advantage. If you don't make this, it is also fine. You can directly calculate in this. You just need to remember what is the interest, this. How we got this? This is the interest. Just remember, interest, what we have got in the first year, multiplied by the tax rate. That's it. This is what figure you will get. Jo bhi interest hai from that previous table, multiplied by the tax rate. I'll get this interest, second year interest multiplied by tax rate, third year interest multiplied by tax rate, fourth year multiplied by tax rate, fifth year multiplied by tax rate. Similarly for depreciation, depreciation amount multiplied by tax rate, okay, for second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. And outflows, I'll minus installment with this and this, interest and depreciation, because this is the advantage which we are getting on tax. So this is not the cash outflows actually. So from the total cash outflow of installment, I'm saving these two amounts. So I'm deducting it. And this multiplied by the PV factor. I've got PV of cash outflows. Then finally, this was again an additional thing. If it is a straight line method, there will be no salvage value. There will be no loss. So this all things will not come if it is a straight line method of depreciation. Okay, so directly you will compare this with the leasing alternate. Okay, so here it was there because salvage value was something. Okay, so these two, I will take this option, 10,28,000. You wanna come here. So that's the reason I'm going to select a leasing alternate. This one statement will be important after the problem. Okay, as cash outflows of leasing alternative is less than the cash outflows of buying alternative, you will select the leasing alternative. Okay, so this is your first assignment. Okay, I'll give it, give this PPT. Okay, don't need to worry, but understand and then only write the assignment. Okay, don't just simply copy this. Okay, understand this, what is happening in this numerical, and then write it. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so I'm open for any questions. If it's there. Yeah, if no questions, then I'll close the session. I'll share this PPT with you.